place your feet on the floor and check that you can bring your hips a little bit like a tilting forward. So the action will be like a squeezing your belly a tiny bit, trying to bring the hips forward and up. So the hips on the floor, yeah? Just tilting the hips so you can feel more the lower back on the floor. You want to feel like the whole spine on the floor, yeah? And then bring the chin toward the chest. You can lift in the head from the floor with your hands, yeah? And then try to lengthen your spine and then place your head back, but keeping the chin toward the chest, yeah? So we lengthen the back of the neck. And then open your arms nice and comfy. Try to spread your arms. Go. And start to soften on the position. So we can focus here or on your breathing, nice and easy, if you can through your nose. Or you can focus on the sensation of your back and your hips on the floor. So slowly you start to surrender the weight of your body to the mat. And as you do that, you can start to notice the different areas of your back. We always have imbalance on our back and the spine. Yes, so start to notice that there are parts of your back that are more on the floor than the other side, for example. Yeah. So slowly with little gentle movements, try to see if you can feel the whole of your back connecting on the floor. Yeah. Don't worry if you can't, just move a little. Yeah. And keep the idea of surrendering the weight of your body into the floor, like a falling into the arms of the planet. Yeah? So imagine the planet as a beautiful, loving space that is open to receive you, to support you. So on the breathe out, the action is to surrender, to let go. And on the breathe in, start to imagine that you are receiving not only your oxygen, you are receiving a beautiful, loving, caring, protective energy. You can imagine always a cocoon around you. You can use a pink light here, like a pink cocoon around you. Pink is the color of loving and caring energy. Yeah? So imagine that you are surrounded by a loving energy, letting go the tension, the stiffness as you surrender to the planet. And we can imagine as well receiving the nourishing energy from the planet. Yeah, so when we breathe in, we receive. When we breathe out, we let go, we soften. Very nice. Well done. So slowly we will lift in the arms up. We will put the arms above you, like over your chest, like you are holding a big ball. Yes, so your arms a little bit roundy, okay? And we will open the arms toward the floor, like you are leading with your elbows down again back to the floor, like your elbows first and then your hands toward the floor. Yeah, opening in cross as well. So we go up. We round the arms and then we go back to the floor with the elbows first and then your wrists and then your hands. Yeah? In this action, we try to spread the shoulder blades. Yeah? So when you go with the elbows, you try to spread your arms more further away. Yeah, with one more. Just to expand your back, yeah? And then we will bring the arms back behind you, yeah, like beside your head. Doesn't matter if it's closed or not. Eh? You can open your arms here and stretch your arms back and try to push the lower back toward the floor. So you will do a little bit of effort with your belly to ground your lower back on the floor as you stretch your arms, chin toward the chest. So you want to feel your spine and your back expanding back, but grounding your hips, yeah, your lower back. And then relax, soften. We will bring one knee to your belly. We catch the knee or your thigh. Let your elbows fall. Yeah, so we can relax the shoulder blades. And softly you press your thigh toward your belly, keeping the chin toward the chest. Each breathe out, you bring the leg closer. This is all this movement that we will do in this series here is for lower back and hips. Yeah? We open the knee to the side. Again, we keep relaxing your elbows. And then we stretch the leg up. We don't extend completely. We always keep a little bit of bending on your knee and we move the leg side to side, just gently. Yeah? And again, we are using like the weight of your leg to ground more and more your lower back and your hips. Yeah? And then we do circles with the leg, gentle circles, yeah, not huge. Keep the leg above your body. And then the opposite direction. And then we move the foot in circles. And we relax, we put that leg back to the floor. We catch the other leg. Again, hands on your knee or your thigh, relax your elbows, chin toward the chest and pushing your leg towards you. Try not to tense too much your arms, yeah? Try to, enough pressure on your leg to bring the leg closer, but without tensing too much your upper body. And then we open the knee to the side. And then we lift in the leg up and we move side to side. And then we roll the leg in circles. And then the foot in circles. Well done. Now we will put that leg over the other knee with the knee open and we bring in that position both legs towards you. Yes, so one is open, one is bending. And again, we bring the legs closer and we rock side to side first. Again, trying to feel that your lower back. This is beautiful for release the tension that we carry on the hip and on your glutes, your hamstrings. For sciatica pain, yeah, for lower back pain. And then we roll this leg in circles. Well done. And then we will work with the other leg in the same position. Yeah? Soften side to side. And then in circles. Well done, very nice. Now, we will bring both legs, yeah? Knees to the belly and we rock side to side. And we do little circles as well. We're bringing the legs closer and then away. And then the opposite direction. Good. And then we will try to catch here. We can catch or the thighs or your shins or your feet, depending what you arrive. But trying to keep the head on the floor, okay? This is a version of the happy baby pose. And we will extend one leg out. Yeah. Now, when you extend the leg, always check that you are not tense in the leg, yeah? And then the other leg. Yeah, out, so we open the inner thighs. Yeah, softly, yeah? So one by one, you can have it on the feet or on your shins or on your thighs, yeah? A gentle opening to warm up the legs, yeah, the inner thighs, that is. In our normal life, we don't use too much the inner thighs, yeah? And then with both at the same time, yeah? So we expand out and open the legs, yeah? And then we bend it. This is also a nice way to work on the knees without pressure, yeah? So spread, expand your back. And it's like we use the weight of our legs to press your back toward the floor. So you spread it and expand, yeah? Expanding out, one more time. Good, well done. So we will put one foot again back to the floor and we will work with one leg now straight forward and back, yes? Yeah? So the knee a little bit bending, as always, not tensing. Flex your foot, you will lead with the heel, yeah? Your lower back is grounding and glued to the floor, yeah? So your belly is a little bit action there to support the position. We will lower the leg as much as we can far away forward and down. We don't have to touch the floor, yeah? So you go further back and down until you feel that the lower back is about to release from the floor, and then you bend the leg, and then you extend it up, yeah? So leading with the heel, you go forward and down, keeping your back glued to the floor. And when you feel that you're about to separate the back from the floor, you release the leg, yeah? So heel, far away, far away, far away, far away, far away. Keep the lower back on the floor, stretch and release. In the next one, we will keep the leg forward. And with your heel, you can move the leg a little bit side to side there, closer to the floor, like a hovering the floor with your heel, far away to feel a nice stretch on your lower back and also on your groin, yeah? But keep the lower back grounding and the belly is a little bit in. So we do a little bit of connection there with your core, with your belly, and then bring the leg back, yeah? Now we put that leg on the floor and we do the same with the other leg. So we extend the leg up, flex your foot, yeah, your toes like a point into your face. And with your heel, we go forward and down, far away until you feel that your lower back is about to arch and then release. You try to go closer to the floor, but you don't have to touch it, yeah? Wherever is okay for you. Grounding your back, your lower back, pushing against the floor as you stretch your leg forward. Yeah, so do it a few times. Far away, far away, far away. Feel the stretching from the heel to the crown of your head. One more time. Good. And then when the next time you stay with the foot there and we try to bring the heel far away and the crown of your head to the opposite direction, pushing with your lower back and your belly toward the floor. And you can hover your heel there a little bit side to side or forward to feel a stretch on your groin, yeah? We are stretching the hip flexor that is a big muscle there that creates a lot of tension, yeah, on the groin. And then relax, yeah? So we will do the last one here. Now we will do the same idea. We bring one knee toward your belly, yeah? Catching the leg on your thigh or on your knee. And we will try to do the same with the opposite leg. We will stretch it with the heel leading the movement. You try to keep the lower back on the floor and you stretch from the heel to the crown of your head trying to bring the lower back toward the floor. Yes, so your heel is pushing toward one side, the crown of your head is lengthening into the opposite direction. You try to lengthen, lengthen your back, lengthen your leg, lengthen your neck. Far away. And then bring that knee back. We change, we catch the other leg, and we go with the other leg extending forward and far away. Far away, grounding. Good, and relax, well done, well done. Both legs to the belly, and we roll toward one side. And we go to all fours. Good. So, hands nice and open, shoulders away, and we move the hips in circles here. Keeping always the shoulders away from your ears, yeah? Breathing forward, breathe out back. And then the opposite direction. Good. And then on the center, breathing open, arching, expanding, shoulders away. And breathe out and round. Breathing open, expand. And round. Now we will curl the toes. We put the back of the toes on the floor, grounding, pushing a little bit with your toes on the floor, yeah? And then pressing toes and hands, arching, 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 head up. And then we round and we squeeze your feet. When you round, bring your lower belly in. And then arching again and curl the toes, expanding, breathing open. Breathe out round. Breathing open. And round. And then we open the knees and we go to child pose. Yeah? So as much back as you can, soften your elbows, soften your head. Try to open your hands enough so your shoulder blades are more or less comfortable. And let your elbows surrender to the floor so you relax your upper back. Let go completely. And then we move the hands to one side. And then to the other side. And then we come back to the center. We will keep the elbows on the floor and we will lift in the hands, yeah? Try to bring the elbows a little bit closer if you can, yeah? Now, don't put the pointy part of the elbows, put more the flesh behind the bone of the elbow, yeah? So it's more comfortable. And you go with your bum back. You can keep the hands in prayer position there above your head, or you can put your hands behind your neck or your back. And you try to soften your hips back and your chest and your solar plexus toward the floor. So you will feel a stretch on your shoulder blades and your arms. Surrender. And then relax. Go to all fours again. And we will bring the arm one arm beneath, we put the shoulder on the floor, we put the head and then the other arm, relaxing as much as you can toward the floor, yeah? Letting go completely. Surrender. And then change, we go to the other side. And we soften. And then coming back, and shoulders away, we open chest, we curl the toes, and we go with the hips up, yeah? And we go back to downward facing dog, yeah? So expand back with your hips, open your chest, like it toward your thighs, yeah, toward your knees. Relaxing as much as you can your chest. Yeah? Whenever you need to release, release. Yeah? Open. And then put your knees on the floor. And we take a nice deep breath, opening and arching your spine. Shoulders again away. Yeah? And when you take the impulse, we will go back to lifting the hips back. Yeah, and we try to bring the chest back as well, yeah, toward the hips, toward the thighs. So breathing, expanding, and then back, hips back, 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 back. Open your chest and relax your head. Keep the knees bending a little, yeah. Open your, like your belly and your shoulder blades toward the thighs. And relax, release, well done. Soften a little bit your shoulders, and we will start with one leg. So arching when you bring the leg back, and then rounding with the belly in when you go forward, without holding your breath, yeah? So breathing back, breathe out forward, a little bit of belly in, but not too much that you have to stop breathing, yeah? Breathing open. The head moves toward the knee and then really back and up. One more time. And last one. Very nice. We put that leg on the floor. We spread back with the other leg, expanding and round. And again, one more time. Well done. And then we will do another downward facing dog here. Yeah? Opening your chest, expanding, curling the toes. We go back with the hips. Back, back, back with your hips, trying to open the chest toward your thighs. The head down. You can look to your feet and trying to bring the belly and the chest toward your knees. That's the intention, yeah? You can move a little bit side to side. And then relax, knees on the floor. And we will go slowly to a standing position. Yeah. Good. Well done. Very nice. So confident. Shoulders away. We will breathe in and expand. And lengthen. Try to check that you are not tensing your knees. Yeah, always the knees soft. And try to spread the sole of your foot. Yeah, your feet nice and open. Try not to put the arch of your foot on the floor. So try to keep the arch of your foot nice and active. So you feel your toes, you feel the ball of your feet, and you feel the heel, the heels, and the outside part of your foot. Yeah. Good. We catch the hands, we go to the side in diagonal. Remember, out and up, not toward the floor. Yeah. Keeping the knees soft, expanding without tensing your shoulders. And then to the other side. Very nice. And then up. Good. Well done. We work a little bit on arms here. Yeah. So we will relax to the side. I show you just a little bit closer. So check that your arms are soft, extending, but not tensing. Because when you tense, you're lifting the shoulders. Yeah, relax your shoulders. And we will comfy with the legs. Yeah? We will bring the arms behind you. Yeah, yeah, perfect. The arms behind you with the shoulders back and down. Then expand and we will bring it up without going into lifting the shoulders. Yeah, okay. So we go open, bend the arms behind you. Spread and like a big up. Yeah. Open, 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 shoulders away, bring the elbows behind you. Like really you are feeling that the shoulder blades are going together, yeah? But check that you are not tensing here. And spread one more time. And expanding, back, back, back. Good, well done. Now we will bring the arm forward. The shoulders are away again, yeah? Back. And we will bring the elbows behind you the same way. But the closer to your back. Again, to bring the shoulder blades together, we are strengthening and stretching your back, yeah? Okay, comfy with the legs. So back here. And when you pull, bring the shoulder blades. This also releases the tension and the stiffness that we have in that area, yeah? Cool. So we do two or three more. Breathe in. Breathe out. Yeah. So when you feel tension on your back, do a few of these movements just to release. Yeah. And last one. Well done. Relax. We will open the legs. So check if it's okay if you put the legs outside the mat. Yeah. Comfy. Yeah. So we will work a little bit different today about the standing postures, okay? So feet parallels, and we will turn one foot to like a warrior two, yeah? So we move the foot, we bend the leg, yeah? Yeah. If you like, yes, put it that way. And sit, yeah? So we will try to relax the hips. It's to work on the hips, yeah? So we will open in warrior two, like we always do, shoulders away. Keep the knee open, yeah? Settle. Relax your shoulders, yeah? Expand, so spread, without tensing, spread, yeah? And we will settle more with the hips, and we will put the arm, yeah? We open, keep relaxing the hips, and spread, yeah? Go, open. We will do a big circle here with this arm. Nice and soft without tensing on your shoulder or your shoulder blade. So a nice soft circle, but big, wherever is possible for you. And then in the next one, we will place that arm on the back leg. We open and we spread the front arm up. We keep relaxing the hip. We look up to the hand and the ceiling and we keep relaxing the hip. Yeah. We bring back the arms. We will rotate to the front. Yeah. And we will open the other foot. Yeah. Relax the hip. In this way, we'll start to open the hip without realizing it. So we open, relax the hip, open the arms, settle. Spread. settle a little bit more. Yeah. Put the arm. Expand. Yeah. Open the arm up. Spread. And then keep relaxing the hip down. And we relax the arm. Nice and big. Big, 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 but soft. Yeah. So it's not an effort. Yeah. It's wherever you can go. Nice and comfy. And one more time. In the next one, we will bring the hand on the back leg and we open and spread. Ah, back and comfy here. Yeah, well done. Now, so try to keep the legs as it, because the leg will start to open. So you try to keep it. Don't close it back. Yeah? So we will move again to the first side. We go to warrior two. We bend the leg first, just to release the hips. Yeah, spread, and then we will push with this thigh back to triangle. Yes. Yeah? So we will push without tensing this knee. Remember, the knee is always a little bit bending. You bring the hips like out and lengthen the arm, yeah? Go so far away, far away, far away, far away, far away. The hip is going that way, your arm the opposite way. And then relax your hand, put it on your knee or on your shin. Open again, lifting your arm. Spread up, yeah? So you ground your hand on your leg, lifting up your body. And then again, we do this big circle that we did before. Expand, yeah? Try to keep the knees soft so you are not tensing too much the knees, yeah? One more time. And then in the following circle, we will take that impulse to go up. We will rotate again to the front. You notice that the legs are opening more and we will go to the other side, yeah? So we will start from here, yeah? Yeah. Cool. We'll stay a little bit more standing, yeah? Yeah, well done. So move the hip out, back. And then again, we go further without tensing, yeah? Far away, 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 and then relax your arm. Open. And expand, yeah? So with the hand that is on the leg, you push against the leg so you can lift in your body. And then we do big circles. Expanding far away. We are stretching the legs at the same time, eh? Far away. Yes, well done, beautiful, well done. And then in the next one, we take like an impulse to lift in your body. Ah, very nice, well done. We try to keep that open. Now feet parallel, yeah? Okay, you stay there. You stay there. So from here, the knees are soft. You move your bum out, your hips out. The knees are bending a little. And we lower with the belly and the chest. Yeah, keep the head up. So put your hands on your knees. So you correct the position of your spine. Yeah? We don't want to go in this position rounding. Out with your bum. You have to feel the stretch here on your hamstring, not on your lower back. Yeah, here is the part that you want to feel that you are stretching. Yeah, that's the correct position. So open the chest. And then we lower with the belly between the legs. And then if you can relax your arms to the floor and let your head fall. Relax your elbows, relax your head. Let go completely. Keep the knees soft. We don't have to force. If we don't touch the floor, doesn't matter. You can hang the arms or you can put your hands on your legs if you prefer. The weight is on your heels, yeah? So you keep the balance. Now we will put the hands on your shins or your ankles and we will look up with the head, expanding and arching your spine. Yes, so we look up, yeah? And then breathe out and relax. Breathing up, expanding open chest. Breathe out, relax. One more time. Breathing open. Breathe out, relax. Well done. And in the next one, we will look up and we will keep going up with the head higher, chest, pushing into the floor, lifting at the same time, expanding, yeah, stay there. We will move the feet out and we will expand like a starfish, open legs and arms without tensing, yeah? So you press into the feet to spread your body like from the belly and the solar plexus without tensing the knees. We want to feel that we are expanding like from the groins, yeah? Expand. Now we will put the hands on your hips. We keep the toes out and we will bend the legs here. Yes. Now you keep going. Eh? The hips are out, remember, yeah? So we are not going forward with the knees. You settle back, yeah? Try to go to a position that you do a little bit of effort, but it's not like a fitness that you are tensing. It's soft, yeah? It's like a yielding on the position, yeah? Good. And we will move in that position, keeping the bum out and back, yeah? We don't go to extending completely the knee. Always keep a nice, soft position for the knee. Yeah, soft. It's not a fitness, eh? Soft. We are working, you are anyway strengthening, but we are working on the stretching as well, yeah? And the release. Good. And then we will go back to the middle and we will move a little bit there. Just subtle movements, trying to keep the inner thighs open, yeah? Relax, yeah? Good. We will turn the feet back to the front and we will go one more time to forward bend, lifting the head, yeah? So look, keep looking to the camera, head. You go like with your belly between the legs. And when you can't go any further, well done, then you relax. Relax, 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 relax. Soft. Good, well. And then softly grounding your hands, you will move slowly your legs and we will go to a sitting position, yeah? Now we will stay sitting. So if you like to adjust your camera, yeah? We will stay sitting and lying down, yeah? Good. So we will go to, we will keep stretching the legs a little bit more. Yes. So we will put the leg forward. Yes. Take your time. Very nice. Yeah. Good. So try to ground your bum here. Yeah. So if you notice that to extend the leg, you have to fall back. Bend the knee a little and go into your bone here. You want to be on the bone of the hip. So your upper body is straight, nice and long, yeah? So with the leg bending or stretching, open your chest and we lead like we did on the forward bend here. So we go with the head up, the hands beside your leg or through the leg. Chin up, keep the chest open, head up. All the way, all the way, all the way until you can't go any further with your belly. Yeah. When you can't go anymore, then you relax your head and your chest. You can keep the hands on the legs or on the floor or toward your foot. No forcing here. Yeah. Now, with your breathing, we will do breathing, looking up with the head, but you keep the body low. Yeah, so just the head and open the chest. Breathe in and then breathe out, soften. Well done. Breathing up. Breathe out, relaxing. One more time. Breathing up. Breathe out, relaxing. Well done. Now really gentle, really gentle. We will move the hands like toward the other leg And we will place it like in the middle, so like a 45 degrees. So this is 90 degrees, you are in the 45, in the center, more or less. Without lifting your body from the floor, you want to be with your hips grounding, yes? So you place the hands and the same, with the head up, you lean toward your foot that is bending here, yeah? Not forcing, eh? But try to keep this hip grounding on the floor. We are working on the hip and the deep flexors there, yeah? Expanding, open chest. Yeah, whatever you can, try to not tense too much the upper body. Well done, well done, well done. With the belly toward the foot, yeah? So you will feel the stretch in both legs here. And then coming back, coming back, coming back. We put the hands behind you or beside you, shoulders away, and we open the chest. Like a lifting with the solar plexus. Yeah, imagine that you are breathing directly with your solar plexus or your heart instead of the nose, yeah? Well done, beautiful. Now, with the leg that is bending, yeah, you will try to cross that leg over the leg that is extending. Yeah? Wherever you can put it. Don't worry if it's not super comfy. Yeah, you ground it as much as you can. You catch the leg and then you push, trying to get a nice lengthened position there. Yeah, well done. Keep the shoulders away, elbows. Now we will twist toward the leg that is bending. Yeah, so in my case, I go this side, so toward your thigh. Yeah, you look toward your thigh, you catch the leg and you start to rotate toward that side. Very nice, very nice. You can place the hand behind you and keep rotating. Soft but big with a nice breathing, yeah? So you keep a nice flowing breath. Well done. Look back as much as you can with your head. And relax, well done, very nice. Now this leg that is bending, we will stretch it forward and we bend the other leg on the side, yeah? And we'll start all on this side. So again, comfy, check. Normally you have difference between our legs, yeah? So could be this more uncomfortable or more comfortable. Ground your bum, open, yeah? Bend the leg if you need. And again, hands, yeah? Lifting the head. So we lead with the chin up. Yeah? Chin, and we lean with the belly toward the thigh. The chest is like a going, trying to go away from the knee. Yeah. Go so. Yeah. Yes, well done. So keep the chin, eh? I know it's a pain, the tablet. Open, 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 open. When you feel that you can't go further, you relax your head. You can keep the hands on the floor, on the leg, wherever you are right. Yeah? And keep the breathing. And then you can try to breathe in, lifting head. Breathe out, relaxing. Breathe in, open head. Breathe out, relaxing, well done. Two or three more in your own rhythm, yeah? So you go with the rhythm of your own breath. Yeah, we have to follow our own rhythm. And one more time. Very nice. Now go a little bit up, just a tiny bit. And again, we will transfer to the center between the two legs, yeah? But we keep the grounding of the hips. So again, you catch your hands on the floor, lifting the chest and the chin, and lean forward with the belly and the chest, yeah? But trying to keep both hips grounding on the floor. Don't go lifting just to go more closer to the leg, yeah? Keeping both grounding. So you go with your belly, with the chest, yes, well done. Keep the head up. The head up in this case is just to keep the spine in a straight position, yeah? To avoid the rounding. And then you can relax, yeah? But no, don't force, whatever is possible. And back. We put the hands behind or beside with the shoulders nice and comfy, grounding into the hips and lifting your chest. Well done. Very nice. Well, now, the leg that is bending on the side, we will cross over. Yeah? We are okay, Madeleine? So put the leg cross, wherever is possible. Catch your leg so you can spread shoulders away, yeah? And again, we twist toward the thigh, yeah? So bring the belly in so you can pass through the thigh and expand back. Relax, well done, very nice. And we do the last one here. We will put the feet together, the sole of your feet together, opening your thighs, pushing into the hips, yeah? Open chest. And we will do this pose lying down, the next one, yeah? So knees open, open chest again with the chin up. You can stay in this position, opening the chest, shoulders away, elbows can be on your knees, yeah? Or you can put the hands on the floor, wherever is comfortable. If you feel that you can lean forward, you put the hands on the floor and you lean forward, but always with the chest, the chin up, yeah? Okay. Just to allow this to work in a nice position. Yeah. Try to avoid in this position the rounding of your back. Yeah? We want chin and head up so the spine is nice and long. Well done. Check that we are not tensing. Yeah, well done, well done. Soften. Yeah, on the breathe out, we can always lean a little bit forward. And then relax. Well done. We stretch the legs. And now we will lie down on the back with this position. Yeah? So we will put the feet together. Oops, I have to change. So feet together, the sole of your feet. Now we do a little effort here to bring the hips again tilting forward. Again, we want to feel the lower back as much connected on the floor. So your belly is a little bit in. Again, your chin is toward the chest. So lifting the head again from the floor to create a nice lengthen of your spine. And then open your arms. Yeah, so we will stay in this position. Could be comfortable, could be really uncomfortable. Yes, just stay for a few breaths, allowing the lower back to go as much as you can toward the floor and softening your inner thighs and your knees. Soften, yeah, relax. And then when you relax, you will notice that maybe the lower back will lift a little bit from the floor. Yeah, that's normal, yeah? Just now focus on let go your inner thighs. Opening, relaxing your shoulder blades. Yes, soften, soften, soften. So imagine the knees are super heavy going toward the floor. You could feel tension on the inner thighs, eh? That's okay. It's not a super relaxing pose unless you are super flexible. Yeah? It's not, we do a little effort here. And that's okay. Yeah? So. And then slowly we will close, gently your legs. And now we will open the feet a little bit more separate, like using the width of your mat. Yeah, so each foot in each side of the mat. And now we will bring the inner thighs closer, your knees closer to each other. We don't have to touch the knees, it's whatever feels okay. Yeah, whatever feels okay. And bring again your belly a little bit in and ground your lower back to the floor even further here. So you want to feel the whole rectangle of your back grounding on the floor. And your inner thighs going together, closer to each other. Don't push too much so you don't feel uncomfortable on your knees. Yeah, whatever feels okay for your legs. Keep the position. And relax. Yeah. And you can move the legs here a little bit in the same position. Yeah. Move your legs side to side, your legs, your knees, one, and then the other one. This is a nice position to release whenever we have tension on your lower back, on your hips. Yeah. Well done. And then we will do just one bridge. Yeah. So we will push. Now we put the feet parallel, normal, hip distance apart. Yeah. So inside the mat. And we will press into the feet with the belly in and we will lift in the bum, chin toward the chest. We want to feel the back of the head and the back of your shoulders there on the floor. Belly in and we go with your groins nice and high. Not tensing too much. Yeah? Try to like stretching. Like you want to move your groins further up to the ceiling. Lengthening the back of the neck. Good. And relax. Soften. We will do the last one. Yeah, and when we are up, we will try to bring the arms behind your back, beneath your back. Yeah, we can catch the arms or not. Yeah, you will try to work with your arms in a way that you can feel the shoulders. Yeah, so you bring the arms beneath you. You can leave the arms like directing toward the feet, or you can catch your hands, whatever feels more comfortable. And work on lifting your groins. Belly in. And then relax, release. And we bring the knees to your belly. And we soften. Good. And we will go to a spinal twist. Yeah? We bring the knees toward one side, opening your arms, nice and comfy. And you can visualize, as always, the cocoon again around you here. Yeah? Now we are more open and receptive, so imagine you are receiving a beautiful energy of relaxation and nourishing energy. And then we go to the other side. Softening. Good. And then we go to Shavasana. Yes, so we lengthen the legs, nice and comfy, open there. And so imagine the support of the planet, the cocoon around you, and we will receive an extra energy of relaxation, comfort, and peace. So imagine this energy ready to enter into your heels, the sole of your feet, your toes, the top of your feet, your ankles, your lower legs, your knees, your thighs, your hips, your lower back, middle back, upper back, shoulder blades. Imagine your arms receiving this energy, your hands, your fingers, and then moving up through your wrists, elbows, shoulders, the back of your neck, the back of your head, the crown of your head, your face, your neck, your chest, your belly. Allowing your body to surrender completely to the floor and going deeply inside now and relax, relax, relax. Now slowly, really slowly, allow your awareness to get back to your body and start doing movements to your hands, your feet, moving your head side to side, bringing your arms back and expand. And we fall slowly to the side and to a sitting position, crossing your legs and breathing deeply. Now give a big thanks to yourself for taking the time to join this class. And I thank you for sharing your time and your practice with me. Thank you.